Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be solving two very interesting problems based on radar range calculation. Before I start with solution, I want you to try those questions first. Later you can check for the solution in this video itself. This is question number one and this is question number two. I hope you might have tried those questions. See, these questions, that is, they're based on my previous videos, in which I have derived this equation of radar range. Using this equation only, I'll be solving these questions. So let us solve first problem over here. See, in question, what is given? You see, calculate the maximum range of radar system which operates at 3 cm wavelength. So here wavelength is given, lambda is equals to 3 cm. Here we have peak power, that is of 500 kilowatt. So here transmitting power, that is given, 500 kilowatt. Here P min is 10 to the power minus 12 volt. Here minimum detectable signal, that is given, that is of 10 to the power minus 12 volt. The capture area of its antenna is 5 m². So here effective area of antenna, that is given, that is 5 m². Target area is of 20 m². So here sigma is target area, that is of 20 m². Whenever you have question at the time, first you just list out all the data that is given to you. After that, you will have to convert this data in terms of SI unit. So here you see lambda is given in terms of centimeter. So that is 3 into 10 to the power minus 2 meter, that you can say. Here transmitted power, that is 500 kilowatt, means 500 into 10 to the power 3, means you can say 5 into 10 to the power 5 volt. Other data, that is already there in SI. So now we have all the data. Now using radar range equation, we can simply solve this. See, radar range that I have derived, right? Maximum range of radar that I have already explained you, that basic equation is transmitted power into effective area square into sigma divided by 4 pi lambda square into S min, and this raised to 1/4. Here we just need to substitute all the data. Here we have transmitted power, that is 5 into 10 to the power 5, 5 into 10 to the power 5 effective area square. So we have effective area, that is 5 m². So 5 square is 25 over here. Here sigma is target area, that is 20 m². Here in denominator we have 4 pi and lambda square. Lambda square means 3 square into 10 to the power minus 2 square, means 9 into 10 to the power minus 4. And minimum detectable signal S min, that is 10 to the power minus 12. You just substitute all the data, right? You just solve this in calculator, you will be getting maximum range of radar. I have solved it. Let me check my answer over here. This is 3.85 into 10 to the power 5, and answer will be there in terms of meter over here. If you have question based on kilometer, then 10 to the power 3 meter means kilometer. So you can say 385 kilometer, that will be the maximum range of given radar with given target area of 20 m², right? Here parameters will change with respect to target area even, right? It is not like range of radar, that is 385 kilometer. Range of radar will be 385 kilometer as if target area is of 20 m². As if target area, that is getting smaller, then radar range will also get smaller over here, right? Let me explain you second problem over here now. See, in second problem, what is given? In second problem, a radar with peak power of 500 kilowatt, that is given. So let me note down the data. Peak power means transmitted power, that is 500 kilowatt, that is given. The power gain of antenna is 5000. So here gain of antenna, that is given, that is 5000. And minimum power of receiver is 10 to the power minus 14 watt. So here S min, that is given, that is 10 to the power minus 14 watt. Calculate the maximum range of radar if the effective area of antenna is 10 meter square. So AE is given, that is 10 meter square. Target cross section is 4 meter square. So sigma, that is given, that is 4 meter square. Now, as I have told you, first of all, you need to note down all the data. After that, you need to convert all the data in terms of SI unit. So here you see transmitted power, that is 500 kilowatt, means 500 into 10 to the power 3, means it will be 5 into 10 to the power 5 watt. Now everything that is there in terms of SI only, right? Here, if you observe, we have been given with gain. In last problem, we were not been given with gain. So we have used that equation, right? I have explained you, see both of this equation. Here, normal equation is PT into GAE sigma divided by 4 pi square into S min. Here, if you substitute G is equals to 4 pi AE by lambda square, then you will be having this equation. In this problem, we have been given with gain. So we'll be using first equation over here, right? So here, let me note down that equation. R max, that is PT into G into AE into sigma divided by 4 pi square into S mean, right? And that is raised to 1 by 4. Now, see, here we need to substitute all the values, all the data that is given to us, right? So here a transmitted power, that is 5 into 10 to the power of 5. Gain is 5000. Here effective area of antenna, that is 10. Target area sigma, that is 4. Divided by 4 pi square into S mean, where S mean is 10 to the power minus 14. And this raised to 1 by 4. Remember, you will have to solve this carefully in calculator, right? Let me check what is my answer over here. My answer for this question, that is 5.01 into 10 to the power 5, and this answer will be there in terms of meter. Sometimes there may be a question based on kilometer. At that time, one should know 10 to the power 3 meter means 1000 meter is equals to 1 kilometer. So if you divide this by 1000, you will be having answer in terms of kilometer. So you can say it will be 501 kilometer over here, right? Here, if you carefully observe these two equations, right, that I have already explained earlier, but still you should know, it is not like which equation should be used in which condition. You should know this radar maximum range, that is PTGAE sigma by 4 pi square into S mean, where usually we use parabolic antenna with radar system where gain is equals to 4 pi AE by lambda square. As if you substitute gain is equals to 4 pi AE by lambda square, then you will be further simplifying that equation in this form, right? So it is not like you will have to remember multiple equations. That you will get to know as if you have some practice. I hope you are getting all these answers as I have explained. Still, if anything that you would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.